Welcome back to The Generation Y. You're with me, Scott Sundiata Keita. Remember to join the conversation. You can go to our Facebook page, TVC Kenya, at Keita Scott, and of course, we'll keep the conversation going. Now, Paul Ogola, back to the conversation. Just seeing how the acting scene is in Kenya, is there a difference between stage acting and screen acting? And for you, where did you start? Did you start directly on screen, or did you have to go through the stage?
I started with stage.
Oh.
And there's a huge difference between screen and stage, because first of all, stage, as a performer, the audience, the response is immediate. The audience are here, so I'm on stage, I'm acting, and the audience are reacting. They're crying, laughing, and they're clicking, all that. So the audience, they're here, but on TV.
You don't see the audience.
The audience is this one.
It's a machine. You can't. It can't react to you.
It can't react to you. Uh-huh. So the only thing you can be told, like, cut. Did I do something? No,
is it hard? Is it hard to switching?
Very easy.
It's
it's very easy. You can't take.
Oh, once easy coming from.
Once you understand it, that when I'm acting to this audience, I have to shout.
Mm-hmm.
When I'm acting to this camera, I have a lapel mic, so I have to be so much when I'm talking to you. But I have to talk to these trees, these birds. I'll be like, hey, you're eating my corn, my maize, get out of there. You know? So that's the difference. On stage, the actions are so wide, but on camera, it's you on the camera. The camera
small bits it of
will
action.
Capture everything.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
So it's different. I started on stage and I had to like understand every aspect of stage, of which I'm still understanding till date. You can't finish them in your lifetime. You have to understand everything. Once you have understood this, then you have to start studying film. That on film, these are things you know, these are do's and don'ts. You know. So they're different, but you can't do without the other.
But there's been a conversation going around that say mostly film producers, actors themselves, the importance of having gone through theater. Is it really that important, or do you can even just go into screen without having that background?
It's very important. if you can find actors who've gone through theater are more advantageous than actors who are just coming to the screen. They are more advantageous because now such kind of actor, you give him a script, it's so easy to explain to him, this is the kind of reactions you need right here. But take a green person from school, pick him, put him, give him a script, you'll find there's a hill somewhere. You have to climb than just getting somebody who has gone through theater. The only thing you need to tweak is his actions.
Is it a challenge for, say, actors coming from theater who have deep backgrounds in theater on stage, switching from the stage where you have to be powerful, getting to screen where you have to be? Is it a challenge?
It's a challenge, for real. It is a challenge that some actors, some theater actors, find it so hard to like adapt to the screen or the film sector. Maybe because they're used to shouting and acting while throwing their hands.
Exactly.
You know, for you to explain to them that this is not screen.
You have to calm it down.
They have to understand a lot of stuff, but that has to happen with yourself. You have to understand it yourself by just researching and you know. Yeah, it's much of research.
Yeah.
Sit down, watch things.
So right now in Kenya, there's no institution that offers this kind of skills. Where did you get your skills from? Did you study for it?
In Kenya, we have film schools, but the only problem is that they are very expensive.
Wow.
I can't afford them myself. But I pray so hard that I work hard. If my kid will have that talent, I will afford
to pay for them to go through
them.
That. Yeah.
But for me, how I learned it is through experience, and I'm still learning.
And of course, your own research.
And my own research. I sit on University of YouTube to watch acting masterclasses.
Oh, I like the way you call it, University of YouTube.
Yes, so many things. I tell you what, so many great people even these camera ladies, if I investigate properly, I'll find that they have tutorials. These cameras.
It's called the Yego generation.
Yego is a world champion.
Amazing.
Through YouTube.
Exactly. Look at that.
Yeah, you know.
So there is no excuse for failure.
I'm not saying that schools are useless. I'm not saying that. I'm not saying that. But I'm just saying, if you can't afford university, but you can afford bundles for YouTube, brother.
Make a use of, make a use of that.
Yeah.
Now, looking at the projects that you've worked on, from WazFM to Half-Life, what other projects have you worked on that people out there do not know about?
Stories of Our Lives. It was a very challenging project. It was I had to play a gay character.
Wow.
Gay.
Wow, that's controversial.
No.
Yeah.
But you know, it's very controversial in Kenya.
Did it sit well with you?
With me?
Yeah, exactly. With you personally, having to do that character, did you find it easy?
When one thing about myself that I know, I'm an actor. I'm a storyteller. I tell stories. But when I tell stories, it doesn't mean those stories are mine.
You? Yeah, exactly.
That's why when I reach this the particular place, I have to remove my clothes and take those that character's clothes. They're called costumes.
And wear them.
So that's not me. My clothes, my me is somewhere in the changing room. So I didn't find it challenging so much as a character, but as Paul, it was very hard. It was very hard. But there's some things we have to know. You have to
Of course, because after the script, people, people are skeptical. Like, really, did you do that?
It didn't have to go after. Even after, when I was shooting, you know, these the extras, they had seen me on Nairobi Half-Life. I was like, what?
This guy. You know this face.
This guy is gay.
Yeah.
And I was like, okay. So I did my job, you know. So
does it disturb you what people think about you, like after you've done a job like that?
It doesn't.
Wow. How do you move past that?
How do I move past that? Mm-hmm. They have to know that at the end of the day, I have to leave.
Mm-hmm. It's your job.
It's my job. Mm-hmm. You know what? We have the government. Mm-hmm. You can see whatever they do, and they're clapping to these people.
Yeah.
So why should you come to me and crucify me for my job, and yet I'm just telling somebody else's story.
Exactly.
And this person is human. If you want to be mad at anyone, be mad at your representatives in the government. I'm just me. Live with it.
Wow.
And I respect you. People respect
for your
me.
Own opinion.
Yes.
Yeah.
Respect me. I respect you. And I love everyone who loves my job. I love everyone who understands that acting is storytelling, and these stories, they are not fantastic or sci-fi. These are people's stories. Because that movie, I'm not trying to advocate for the gay. What I'm saying is that movie, this is what it was asking. It was a very simple question. We have the gay. Then what?
Then what? Wow. I like the fact that you have such a free spirit about what you do, and especially how you embrace your work.
Yeah.
But again, coming back to your work and having worked with Tom Hanks, the Wachowski brothers, how do you get, what was the experience like, just to start with that?
Being directed by Tom Tivo for the second time, that was a humbling experience.
Wow.
Because the first time he helped directing Nairobi Half-Life, but the director was Tosh Gitonga.
Yeah, Tosh Gitonga, of course.
But Tom Tivo came back. It's because of him the project came back.
Oh, it was a competition, I think.
Yes, it was. And it was very challenging because it was when Kenya had insecurity issues. So the job was supposed to go somewhere else.
Exactly.
The Wachowskis never knew about Kenyan performance.
Wow.
And they were not that sure about Tom brought it home. So when they came and I went for the auditions, Sense8 auditions, me being picked and being briefed about the project, I was so I don't know, speechless.
I know you should be so psyched and stuff.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
And I was told the person I'm going to work with, Amal Amin. Then I, you know, you have
Google.
To research who's this guy. And to research you know, go to know about Amal Amin.
Google is your friend.
The things he did. Wow. And I was like, you know what, this is it. This is my chance to audition again.
Amazing stuff.
And during the shoots, the Wachowskis came. Then I was told, this is Lana, this is Andy. These are the guys who made the Matrix trailer.
Matrix.
Jesus Christ.
Imagine
Wow. Then Tom took me, Tom Tickver took me and introduced me to, this is Jeff.
Wow.
Polo-Gola. And wow. The first thing Andy Wachowski's told me.
One of the Wachowski's.
Yeah, they came and they went through the rushes and they said, wow, you gave us more than we expected. Okay, this is not.
Wow.
This is not Alfred Mutua shooting Cobra Squirrel.
This is not some Nigerian film promo kind of a thing.
This is Wachowski's.
Wow.
Given, did you just say that? They said it. And I was like.
So getting a compliment for the Wachowski's, it was, of course.
This is it.
This is it.
This is it. Keep on auditioning.
Wow.
So I did whatever I have to do. All the eight shooting days I had for the Sense8.
Mm-hmm.
I shot for 8 days. Mm-hmm. I did everything I could and keep crossing my fingers that it, when it comes out, it gives me a recognition. And after it came out, it was great.
And that's how.
I mean, on Twitter, I had like 213 followers. Actually, not even 200. Below 100.
And then after
Twitter, I have like 800 loyal followers. Jesus Christ, I love that. I don't need thousands.
What?
I need like only 200 loyal.
You're like a midnight celebrity. 15 minutes of fame. I mean,
it's just season one. We have season two coming.
We're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about the season two and how it's going to be. You're watching The Generation Y with me, Scott Sundiata-Keita. We'll be right back.